What's up, game devs? Let's say you have a Venusaur that spawns frequently and a Dinosaur that is less likely to be found. Today, we're gonna talk about, you read in the title, building up a system to obtain random items from a list where each item has a given weight or probability. This means you can either split your probability with a fixed percentage, that is basically the case where the sum of all weights is 100, or work with relative probability, that is much more flexible and relies, for example, in defining that an item has twice the chance of another item to spawn. With this 15-line script, you can make it really easy, flexible, and customizable for all the needs of your game. As always, the code is available for free on GitHub, so you can just copy and use it. Please hit subscribe and let me know in the comments down below if you find it useful. I'd love to know how you use the script in your game. Ready? Let's move on from the intro and dive into the action. Our entire logic is inside this really short script. You can see in the hierarchy that I have three more C# files, but they're only meant to make the UI work on this demo, so they're not actually required for the loot table. Anyway, the code is on GitHub, so you can always have a look, link in the description. The interesting part begins with this class, that is not extending from mono behavior but scriptable object. Make sure you also include create asset menu here, so that when you go on the editor, you can right click and under create, you will find loot table. That is just this loot table we defined under menu name. If we expand the class, you can see that we have three fields. The first is a rewards item list, the second a boolean that we need to keep as non-serialized so that is not persisted in our object. And the third is total weight, we're going to explain that in a moment. Our reward item is a simple class that holds our statistics for the item we want to spawn. So it's gonna have a name, probably a sprite, we could add a damage and any other value. But one we need to add for sure is the weight, and the weight is our probability for this specific item to spawn. The first method that shows up here is initialize. Without this method being called at least once before we use getRandomItem, the system is not gonna work. So we add a boolean check here that if it's not initialized, we just do the total weight, that is the sum of all items, and we set the value to true, so this is not executed once again. As you can see here, we do that by this function that is .sum. And we can use it because we imported system.linkU that brings a lot of cool functions such as min, max, and last or default. You can find a lot of those. You could even use an old approach that is a for each on each item in our list. That's the exact same function, but I think with linkU it's much easier to read. The core logic of the entire system is the getRandomItem method. It is fairly short, but I want to show it to you running with the debugger. So we can start it from here. Let me know in the comments if you would like an entire video on how to use the debugger, by the way. And we can launch the editor. You see we have four items, one with 50% chance of spawn, then 25, 20, and 5. Let's say we want to try with three items, we hit generate loot. So, we can start debugging with the initialize function. As our initialized boolean is false, we enter this if statement. We get our total weight, that is 100, and you can find it is the sum of 5 plus 20 plus 25 plus 50, our weights. Then we roll our dice. We got a 44. And we can check for each item in the list if the dice roll is smaller than the weight. So the first one is 50, our dice roll is 44, and the first item is a wooden sword. There you go. Then the second, our roll is 86, that's gonna take a little bit longer. So the first item has weight 50, is not greater than the dice roll, so our dice roll get removed the weight of the first item, this 50. Second iteration, second item. We have the iron sword that has weight 25. Our dice roll now is set to 36. It's not yet our item. The next one, we got the diamond sword that has weight 20. Our dice roll is set to 11. And that's our next item. The third item, once again dice roll 62. First item 50. Is it greater? No. Second item, we got weight 25. The dice roll is now 12 because it was 72 minus 50. That was the first weight. So there's our third item. Now, if we stop the debugger, you can see we have the wooden, the iron and the diamond sword we just received from the algorithm. To make sure our system works, we can boost the numbers a little bit. Let's say we want to generate 1000 swords, and you're gonna see that the generated amount is pretty close to our weight. I can do it a few times, even increase the number. It's also super quick. Now, we have 100 as a base. We can switch to a full relative system so that we can say that the iron sword has a weight of 4, so it's gonna spawn twice as the diamond sword with a weight of 2. We could also put a really, really small number for the golden sword. Stop the editor, start again. So the initialize function gets the right values here. And if you get 100 items, you see that, oh, nice, we got a golden sword. As you can see, we only get one because the weight is really smaller compared to the other. In case you want to expand the system, you can just add a new item here. We want to add a stone sword that is as common as the wooden sword, so a weight of 5. If we hit play, there you have it, the stone sword. If you want a new loot table, you can just create a new one from the scriptable object and give it new values from here. And there you have it! I'd love to hear from you if you're gonna use this script in your game. Feel free to write it down in the comments, and please don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Stay healthy and see you soon!